Good. Mm-hmm. Good. We'll talk a lot about letting contact happen naturally. Uh-huh. Okay. Because straight line, if I run this way and this way at the same time in the same position, I'm gonna eventually hit each other.
Uh-huh. Okay.
So if I drive in a straight line and continue driving in the same line the ball's coming on, eventually I'm going to run into the ball if I stay on the line. Okay. So if that's the case and I know that, then I just focus on continuing to do that until I run out of room and it comes. Because contact is almost gonna surprise me, because if the ball was moving, you don't know right now when you swing if you're early or late until you hit it.
Uh-huh.
Right? Okay.
So go ahead. Is that like a more of a bottom hand drill than a top hand
yes,
drill?
Yes, absolutely. Because okay. You know a lot of folks do top hand.
Yeah.
Okay. And what happens is their top hand gets more dominant. With even you, you're a right-handed thrower and a left-handed hitter. So truthfully, your dominant hand is your bottom.
Uh-huh.
But because you do top hand drills in the swing, your top hand is more dominant. Uh-huh. Wants to be, because it wants to work that direction.
Yeah.
So we kind of have to, we reprogram. I don't do top hand drills. I go straight to the bottom hand.
Okay.
Because if perfect. This works right, then this one's going to fall in line if I can keep it loose.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I like that a lot.
It makes sense.
It does.
I mean, it makes a lot of sense.
It does. Because yeah. Now that I see it, the top hand is just here for natural support.
It's just keeping the bat light.
It really doesn't do anything. It follows this hand.
Yes.
So you really don't need this hand.
I could hit the ball fairly hard with that hand right there and that bat if I had strong enough tricep to get it there.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. All this does is just extra
all that
support.
Does is just make the bat lighter. Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah.